You see, the rules are so clear and there are so many honk sounds. You keep on honking and honking, they ain't care about the noise pollution. They just honk in the city. Strange. Well, I'm waiting for my friends to fetch me to a school. We're gonna see a school today, or some school today. So hopefully, it'll be a good thing. So here we go, in the car now, and off to the school. So here we are, but we are late for school. Because the students are leaving, there's a jump out ahead. Honking again, keep on honking and honking. We can't understand why. The crowd are blocking each other, and they are pushing each other, and they could squeeze in. I wonder whether I can able to get to the school. Even the vehicles doesn't give way to the people walking around. And it's so frustrated, and I don't know how the people here handling the situation every day. They are managed to get in, and I see some bikes and scooters at the side, and they ain't care about broken people pavement. So it's very ridiculous, and the cars, and the people, the crowd, just pushing each other. Wonder how the kids pull through before and after school every day. Many bikers are there and they are just waiting to go out, and they have nowhere to go out, they just have to wait there every day. We are fetching their children. I've got to speed up and hopefully I can see the school. Yes, coming school, coming, coming, and that's the school gate. Finally, I get off this place. So now we are in the school and there's a table tennis here. Ping pong table, and so we see the notice board and one boy looking at the notice board. I think he's waiting for his parents to fetch him. And go on and we'll see other school. And this is the school building. And me going inside there, not going there, sneak inside the school. And you see on my left, yeah, on my right, nothing. I think no one in the school right now. Let's go up and go this place, and there is a washing area, but strange thing is that there's no toilets. Or here the school, the classroom, and their bus to protect them. Yep, and there we'll see a lot of things around here. Let's see, it's small here, the school building is very small. Let's go up and see again for more things. And here we are, the classroom, and managed to sneak in without any people knowing me I'm here. So here are the stools, you see all the stools, and the tables. It's very old and broken, and it's really broken. Yep, let's go to another one, and we see benches. So the students sit on the benches for their study, and the old desk. So let's go down and go to another place. So here what you can see outside the school, the shops, and people on the scooters, the vehicles, and even taxi here. So this is what it looks like outside the school. And you even can see some people growing their vegetables anywhere near the school. And these are the vegetables they planted. And so their space, they should plant some vegetables anywhere they like. So here's the street outside the school. The people here ain't care about noise level, they keep on honking their feet. They ain't care about environment. The people talk very loud most of their time. People are selling fish. And here we've got the street food on the bike. There are fish, chicken, sausage, and some of the things that you know what they are. But their range is only $1 per sausage, despite the unhygienic way of handling the food. The noise level here is very high. Didn't experience much, so we went to another school on the next day. Some miles away, and here's the school. And this place very strange, the doors, the gates are locked, and I can't get into the classroom, but I can hear children playing can hear children studying. Hopefully I can get into one of the classrooms so that I can even see what they are doing inside. Finally, I managed to sneak into one of the classrooms and this is what they are doing in the classroom, and the game team, she saw me and I better get out here before the teacher chased me out. And I got a recommendation from a friend to go to another school, so I hope this time will be very fruitful. Just can see people walking on the road without looking at the cars and very dangerous driving here. Really dangerous, because any time can knock a person down if we ain't careful. See what I mean? The people ain't care about the road. They don't care about the cars going around them. They don't care about what's behind them. They just walk slowly without looking at the cars, and you have to be careful when driving. Lao Zi means crazy. My friend teasing me, why do I want to come to this town to investigate the people's life? But coming here is a good experience for me. It's an eye-opening to see how the people are living in this place. So here is a parking lot for people parking the cars. These are apartments they live. And these are the friends and so-called volunteers helping me to investigate the town. Here we are, approaching the school gate. I think these are apartments for the school staff to stay. After 10 minutes, the parents come into the school to fetch their children. Crowded. A lot of people are getting around the school to see their children and waiting to fetch them. And you still can hear home sound again, everywhere. Okay, the school gate open and the parents are rushing in. The parents are finding their children in the school with the hope they won't lose them. Yeah, the children are running around and the parents are looking for them. The school announcer said the teachers have worked hard. So where are the teachers? Why didn't the teachers bring the children to see the parents? Instead, the parents had to find the children. No wonder there's a lot of news about kidnapping in China or parents losing their children. Many people are around here and the parents are hoping to find their children to bring them home safely. Let's go into one of the classrooms and see them. Here we are, the church is there, and this is the classroom. Let's go to the second floor. Carrying the staircase is low and narrow. We can hear the school music start playing. So these are the classrooms. So if you see kids playing rooms. In China, the kids are told to clean the classroom every day before leaving. because some parents looking for their children. One thing that curious me is the toilets. Until now, I didn't find any toilets in this school, even for the other two schools. So let's find a toilet. I don't believe they can hold their pee and poo for the whole day. Where is the toilet? I've been moving around and hardly see any toilet around. Here ain't no toilets, ain't no restrooms. That may be the one with a bit run down. Yep, that's the toilets. Let me confirm with this boy. So here I am, going to the boys' restroom. Can you believe it, these are the toilets? The smell is intolerable and the people are seeing and next to each other, seeing them peeing and pooing. And there is no water systems. That's very ironic. Let's get out of here. So we have visited three schools and this will happen if they ain't care about the noise, they ain't care about hygiene, they ain't care about environment, the crowd, and the toilets as well. So this is how they live their lives. Oh, do the exact thing.